I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do.
Mercutio, why can't we just go inside? It's so cold.
I swear, mate, you've gone soft.
I really don't want to fight anyone today.
You're the type to just throw up their arms and say, I'm not a fighter.
Please, not in my lifetime.
Remember that time we went to the pub? You slammed your sword down and said those exact words. You didn't take it out again until when you were drunk. You threatened the bartender. It's a good thing he knew us.
Yeah, I was drunk. But really, am I that kind of guy?
I mate. But I know you think you're not a fighter, but you've got a flame in you. Brightest in the capital.
Sure.
Jeez. Capulet firearm!
Do you really think I care who's shooting at us? What's going on out there?
Capulet. Probably Tybalt and his boys. And apparently they've stopped.
Gentlemen! It's a fine evening, is it not?
So that's how it's gonna be then.
Now listen! I demand to speak with one of you! We can do this the easy way, or the hard way. And I really hope you give me option number 2.
Romeo, let Mercutio and I go.
No, I won't let you do this.
We both know Tybalt wants your head, mate. He won't kill us right off the bat. We'll talk the little smeg away.
We'll go.
One word, all right?
Not much can be said in only one word. Well, tell you what, make it a word and a blow.
You'll find this a fantastic time for that girl. You have an opportunity right now, just waiting to be released, don't you?
Can you specify?
Mercutio, friend of the Montagues. You're associated with that scum, Romeo.
Associated with? Listen, you slack-jawed little git. I ain't just associated with him. He happens to be my best mate. What do you think I am, some servant? Personal bard? Oh, look, my fiddle in one hand and my stick in the other. Well, you're gonna dance?
Mercutio, there's service cameras around.
Relax, I've got this.
We were planning on convincing him away. If we've got to do this, we're gonna have to do it someplace quieter where we can't be seen.
Come on, let's give those cameras a show.
So, the man of the hour, hiding behind his friends.
You two, married or something?
Even if I was interested in cogs like you, or men for that matter, it wouldn't be Romeo. He's nothing but a swine, a villain.
You're my brother now. We have to stop this.
Shut up! I'm no brother of a Montague such as yourself.
But I'm no villain. Seems we've reached an impasse. I'm sorry for all the things that have happened many, many years ago, but you've just got to leave that thing behind. You don't know anything.
You think a simple apology will mend the shame you've caused me? The torment of having a Montague stain my family with your bad romance!
Tybalt, back down! I don't want to fight you!
You hold no honor in those words. No honor! No honor! Shut up!
Let's just get rid of him already.
Hey, We can't fight! I will not do this!
You rat bastard! If we're gonna do this, let's do it the right way.
So what would you have with me, girl?
Well, King of Cats, how about one of the 9 lives?
So it's death you choose, girl.
Don't think I'll show any mercy. Romeo, come back!
Why'd you drag me in here?
Mercy can handle herself.
I need to go help.
Romeo!
Romeo, get back!
Any last words, girl?
Just a scratch.
No!
Well, brother, what are you waiting for? Do it!
Romeo, Tybalt and Mercutio, they're both dead. I killed them. There's service cameras everywhere. You have to go.
No one needs to know.
You just go already. Go.
What is all this? Two dead bodies? What? What just happened here? I was just having my morning bath, and then all this commotion, gunshots, yelling, what?
Speak!
It's really complicated. It's Kay. Tybalt came and started shooting at us, and we were just trying to defend ourselves. So we were fighting, and Tybalt slew Mercutio. And Romeo, he got so angry, so he slew Tybalt.
Liar!
Restrain yourself, Capulet!
No! He killed Tybalt in ice cold blood, and you're trying to frame my poor nephew in his own death!
Shut your cog!
Hey,
I do not tell lies!
Whoa!
Do not speak to me like that, or I'll have your head!
I am the Emperor! Does no one know this?
My liege, I am sorry.
Okay. Romeo killed Tybalt. Who killed Mercutio? Who pays for the crime? All right. You all know that Romeo was a good friend of this Mercutio. So Tybalt was the one who killed Mercutio. In an act of vengeance, Romeo killed Tybalt. Makes sense. So from then onwards, I can't really condemn this man to death. Though I did say before, and I will say again, he will not go without punishment. He shall be banished forever from this day of Verona. From this very second, he shall be banished. If he comes back, we all know what will happen to him. He will not like it. And you two are not allowed to go finding this man, because if you do, I will have your heads just like everybody else's. Comprendez-vous?
Hello, Mr. Romeo. Mrs. Montague. So strange, being in love and not being able to see him, to be with him. I wish I didn't have to be caught up in all the stupid feuding. I wish he could be right here, in my room, right now. Oh, what I wouldn't do to feel his arms around me. I wish it were just him and just me. Hey, nurse. I didn't hear you there. I didn't see you coming. You didn't knock.
I wish I hadn't heard you.
Do you have any news from my Romeo? Have you been crying? What happened? What's wrong?
It's oh heavens, he's dead!
What? No, this can't be. I held his hand just hours ago. Fate cannot be this cruel.
Oh, what curse is cast upon us to deserve this tragedy?
Better not have anything to do with your mindless infatuation.
Just tell me, nurse, was it quick? Did my beloved Romeo die painlessly?
Wait. Hold up. Romeo? It never said anything about Romeo. What's it with you? Like, do you really think that that's all, the only person that can die in this world? Like, you didn't even think of anybody else who was also a fighter.
Gah, teenagers. But I asked about Romeo, and you said he was dead.
Of course he isn't dead. Why would I be crying over some steam-powered, cowardly, yellow-bellied, slovenly steampunk?
It's your dear cousin, Tybalt, who died at the hands of your beloved.
Oh, Tybalt, why did you have to be ever so fabulous?
So Tybalt is dead? And Romeo killed him? That can't be true.
Yes, Romeo killed Tybalt, and now that image is imprinted in his conscience forever. Well, even more now that he's been banished for cutting up our family like ground beef.
How could the devil be in such a beautiful face? He's hot, then he's cold. He's yes, then he's no. He's dead, then alive. Alive, but banished. But he is alive. Romeo, the love of my life, is alive. To the death of my cousin Tybalt. It must not have been his fault. He must have been baited or something.
Get your head out of the hard drive, girl. This steampunk killed one of your own.
How could I say such a thing about my own husband? My own would have killed him if he'd had the chance. No. These tears, they must be sending an error report right now because they are clearly crying for joy and not for sadness.
Ugh! I've had it with you. If you want to backstab your dead cousin, go ahead, be my guest. Freaking emo little.
But this is like a backstab to myself. A critical hit with mini crits. Ugh. No. I can't take this.
Well, I guess I've got to admit that I still love you, being your fake real mom and all. I'll go find that scumbag, husband of yours. He's probably hiding in the corner like the hairball that he is.
Oh, you will? Oh, thank you, nurse. Here, give this USB to him. Let it be a token of our last goodbye.
Yes, Peter, what is it?
It's County Paris, sir. He wishes to speak with you.
Does he not know that this is bad time?
County Paris wishes to speak with you about Juliet.
Send him in.
Oh, powerful Capulet. General of the Capulet Cyber Force, I wish to make business with you, if that's all right.
Count Paris. Please, sit. It's unfortunate, the hour that you have come.
I heard. I'm truly sorry for the loss of your commander and nephew Tybalt, sir.
Yes, it is a truly sorrowful passing. But I assume you're here to speak to us about Juliet?
Why, yes, sir. I want to take that fine girl of yours and have her as my own.
Sorry to disappoint you, but we have not had time to convince her of the marriage yet. Things are just unlucky as of this hour. She loved Tybalt, as did we all. Eventually, our circuits break down, our models become obsolete. We are all born to die. Look, I don't think she will be coming downstairs tonight. And to be completely honest, if you hadn't showed up, I would have gone to bed an hour ago.
Indeed. These dark times are no time for romance. Sir, madame, send my regards to your daughter.
I shall go tomorrow morning to see what she thinks of the marriage. Maybe the mood will be less grim when morning comes.
Count, I will make sure my daughter loves you. She will do what I tell her. No. She will do what I tell her and more. Yes, wife, visit her room before you go to bed. Tell her everything. I have no doubt she will marry this handsome, rich young man.
Let us not forget my end of the deal. I marry a daughter, you get shipments of weapons and munitions for your army and take out the Montagues in this feud. Perhaps fighting is the way to end it all.
Yes, the ordinance. Well, dear Count, we shall arrange a marriage for... what's the date today?
Monday, good sir.
Monday, hey? Well, there go my Wednesday plans. Thursday, then. On Thursday, Juliet will be married to you, Count Paris. Will you be ready?
Husband, do you think we are rushing? Tybalt was just killed. And if we have a wedding right as he died, people will start to think we hold no honor for our soldiers or our family.
Perhaps you are right. A small ceremony. Half a dozen friends will be at this wedding. We will hold a funeral for Tybalt in the morning, and later that night, the wedding for Juliet and the Count.
Excellent. Oh man, I wish Thursday was tomorrow.
Thursday, we will join with the Paris Armaments Company through the marriage of our daughter to its CEO. Thursday, we will mourn the loss of Tybalt, knowing his honor will live on. Thursday marks a new era for us as Capulets. An era where we destroy the Montagues.
I still get my wife right, though.
Yes, you still get your wife. Right. Well, it is late. I think I shall retire to my quarters for now. All this is exciting. Lady, go speak to Juliet before bed.
I know.
Good. Count?
Until Thursday, sir.
Yow!
Juliet?
Yes?
Your mother's coming to talk to you.
Open your dang windows!
Ugh, the sun's out already.
Ugh, what's the point? Light comes in, and life goes out.
Ah, you emo little. Okay, let's just let in the sunlight, get up out of bed, and for the love of God, please, cheer up.
What does Mother want to talk about?
I don't even know. God damn it, Juliet. I'm a nurse, not an email. Just talk to her, and for the love of God, please don't talk about Romeo.
Is she in there?
Yeah, whatever.
Who is?
Guess who?
What, Mother?
Are you awake, Juliet?
Mother, I'm not well.
Come now, Juliet. You will not bring Tybalt back with your tears.
Please, just let me be alone.
Tybalt will not feel your sorrow. Besides, that villain who killed him is still out there.
Villain? What villain?
Romeo. Romeo Montague.
But he's not a villain.
Well, may God pardon him. I know he has my pardon. And yet no man can make my heart grieve like he does.
That is because he is still alive.
And yet he is far from my reach. I wish I could see him.
To avenge Tybalt. I mean.
No need, Juliet. You'll see, we have sent an assassin to kill that gear-headed swine. One inconspicuous nanovirus does a lot to kill a man.
Wait, no, don't. Let me inject the virus. I was closest to Tybalt. It would mean a lot to me.
Alright, I guess I can get the assassin to instruct you on how to inject nanovirus. But you can turn your frown upside down! I have important news to tell you.
What now, Mother?
You are so lucky. Your wise father has arranged a date that will make your life so happy.
So, what's the news?
He has agreed to marry you to the CEO of Paris Armaments.
Wait, what?
The great county Paris! I never believed that a hunk like him would want you, but...
Well, thanks, Mom. But I'm not getting married to County Paris. I've never even met this guy. I mean, Tybalt just died. And you want to marry me off? Just go and tell Father that I will not be getting married. Not to Paris, at least. I'd rather kiss a Montague.
Juliet. There's your father. You can tell him yourself.
What? Tell me what? Did you tell her the news, wife?
I have told her, sir. She will not listen to anything I say.
What madness is this? You! Are you insane? We have finally found a perfect man for you. He is way out of your league, and yet he chooses to marry you.
No, Father, I am thankful for what you did for me. But I will not marry a man with fried circuits like his.
What the hell do you think you are doing, you spoiled little brat? You dare shame me like this? Now you will get ready for Thursday, where you will go to St. Peter's Church and be married to this man. And if you do not, I will drag you by the wires to your marriage. You disgust me. You disgusting piece of trash.
Shame on you, Juliet. Have you short-circuited?
Father, please, I'm begging you, just let me explain.
You worthless piece of... If you do not go through with this wedding, do not think of returning to this house.
No, Father, please.
You are nothing but a curse. Thank the Maker we didn't have any more children like her.
Sir, if I may, it might be wrong to berate her.
You shut your mouth, you old hag.
I've done nothing wrong.
We don't need your chatter.
Husband, we may be too harsh here.
I would have loved to see you be happy and married. Honestly, I would have loved to see you happy. But if you do not wed this Thursday, you can starve and die for all I care. Think not of yourself as a Capulet, but as an ugly urchin. Who will die in the streets?
Mother, please.
Juliet, I'm done worrying about you. I'm done.
Nurse, why is this all happening to me? I've done nothing wrong. My husband is out there somewhere, and my vows to him are in heaven. Don't you have some advice to give? Something nice to say? Anything? Please, I just need comfort.
Listen, Juliet. Romeo's been banished. And seriously, I think it might be for the best.
To be honest, if he did come back, he'd have to be like a friggin' ninja to get in. Right now, I think you should marry the Count.
Well, look on the bright side. He is one fine-looking boy. Romeo's a dirty old cog compared to him. If you catch my drift. Huh? No? Okay. But seriously, you should be happy in this second marriage. It may not be happier, but it is better. Your marriage to Romeo is over.
Is that from the heart?
And the soul. And if I'm wrong, well, you can smother me in barbecue sauce and throw me in a cage with lions. Don't actually do it, though.
Go, nurse. Tell Mother that I'm going to see the Padre. I'm going to ask for forgiveness. I have angered Father.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Romeo, come quickly! He'll be found!
Thank you, Padre. I didn't think the Emperor would send guards to find me. I just want to know what the news is. What is my punishment?
The Emperor has made the gentle and God-blessed decision to not have you killed. However, he has decided that you will be banished from the capital.
What about those guards?
They are probably there to make sure you leave.
No. No! This is worse than death itself, Padre. He might as well just kill me now. Exiled. More like damned.
Romeo, my boy. This world is broad and wide, and there is so much to see and do. You can handle being banished from the capital.
But this world, it's a cold, harsh place. The walls of this capital protect us. To be pushed out of its gates is like being locked out of heaven itself. And sent straight into the depths.
Romeo, you focus on naught but the negative. You have committed a sin punishable by death, and the Emperor is forgiving enough to let you live another day. And let me tell you, the Emperor is not as forgiving as I am.
This capital is heaven. It is where Juliet, the love of my life, lives. And to be in a place where I cannot see her is torture, not mercy. Damned men use the word banished to describe their worst of their punishments. I'm going straight to the world of infernal devices.
Romeo, listen to me for one moment.
Shut up! You're going to talk to me about banishment? Like my life isn't crushed enough. I ought to pull the trigger.
Romeo, stop this madness! I will not allow you to kill yourself.
Oh, that's it, isn't it? Suicide is a sin, right? Well, then you do it.
No! I will not end your life to suit yourself, you madman!
But what will I do, Padre? I'll go mad if I don't see her. If I stay, I'm condemned. If I leave, I'm damned. Sprung springs, Padre. I don't know what to do.
Romeo, you must hide. Who is it?
It's me, Lawrence. Remember?
Oh, great. Look, now is not a good time to talk about that thing.
No, not that, you stupid old crane. I come on behalf of Juliet. A message for Romeo.
Yes, what is it?
Well, not a message from her, but I thought I should tell you this. She weeps for you. Wishes you were there with her. If the Capulets found out that I was behind all of this, I'd be shot.
But what is it?
Tonight, I'll shut off the security systems in the household. You can sneak up to Juliet's quarters and say a last goodbye to her. I may not like you, Montague, but my Juliet does. And so it is my duty to make sure she is happy.
Oh, thank you, nurse. I've no idea how to repay you for this, though.
Just taking a shower is good enough. Maybe wash your clothes, too. Oh, and here, a USB from her.
I will never forget this, either of you. It makes me sad to leave, but tonight I will experience the most joy I will feel for a very long time.
Hey, Juliet.
Romeo! Oh my God!
So good to see you.
How did you get in here?
It's lucky the sound systems were off.
What?
Nurse, long story. I came to say goodbye. You know my punishment.
I know. I wish it didn't have to be this way.
Me too. Life's too short, you know?
Far too short. Do you think? I wish. But tonight, I'd rather you just be here with me, comforting me. Romeo?
Yes?
Do you think you shall ever return?
Like, of course I want to. I just don't know. The sun will be out soon. That means the guards will be out.
Must you go, though?
I know that I'm going to be condemned if I stay. If I go, there might be another chance that we could see each other.
I understand. I still kind of wish you had messaging implants, though.
Not my thing. I should go, though.
Okay.